Lecture 26 on Unit 3, Tutorials on Development Length. So yesterday we discussed about different codal provision for development length and what is bond, what is anchorage, what is development length, and how do you find the equation. We derived the equation also, and also we have discussed about how to provide anchorage for the bars in tension, compression and shear. Okay. Today we will do some tutorial on that, numerical on this, to better understand. Okay, the first one, a simply supported beam of size 300 by 700 mm is reinforced with 6 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars as tensile reinforcements with an effective cover of 40 mm, among which 4 bars are continued into the support. Check the development length at the support if the shear force at the critical section is 200 kN. The width of the support is 300 mm. Use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. There is something wrong here. Okay. So this is the problem where you have been size is given, size of the beam is given. So obviously it is a simply supported beam of size 300 by 700 mm reinforced with 6 number of 20 mm diameter bars as tensile reinforcement with an effective cover of 40 mm, among which 4 bars are continued into the support. What does this mean? For example, if you have a simply supported beam, something like this. This is a support. Suppose if it is carrying UDL, obviously bending moment will be maximum at the center and the parabolic variation, right? This is the bending moment diagram. This is WL square by 8, you know, WL square by 8. But it should be WUL square, L effective by square by 8. Okay. Now, at the center point where the bending moment is maximum, there you have 6 number of bars. Okay. But when you go towards the support, when you go towards the support here or towards the support, your bending moment is 0 here, bending moment is 0. So, at the support, you have only 4 number of bars. Okay. At the center point, you have 6. Suppose if you draw the rods here, let us say this is a tensile reinforcement. So you have 6 bars like this. 6 bars will be in the middle portion. Okay, 6 bars. But in the support, out of which 2 are curtailed, only 4 are there at the support. Okay. So that is what this means. Now you have to find out the check the development length at the support. At this support, you have to check the development length. Either this support or this support, both are one and the same. Okay. So everything is given. And they are asking you to check whether this we have provided 4 number of 20 mm diameter bars at the support. Is there sufficient or not? Okay, that is the question. Development length. Check the development length. The question, you pay very careful attention to the question itself. Check the development length at the support. If the shear force at the critical section is 200 kN. Okay. So we will see one by one how to do. So first, as usual, given data. So first thing is, you have been given the cross sectional size. Is it a effective size or overall size? Anyone? Overall size. So the B is 300 mm and 700 mm is the overall size. 700 mm. Now at the support, this is a cross section of the beam. You have 4 number of 20 mm bars. That is B. Capital D is 700 mm because it is not given as effective size. AST at support, I am writing AST at support. At support, there are only 4, among which 4 bars are continued into the support. So 4 into pi by 4, 20 square is 314, so 1256 mm square. Effective cover to the reinforcement is 40 mm. This is a part, effective cover is 40 mm. Now this is shear force at critical section is 200 kN. Is it a shear force? Is it due to working load or design load or this one factor load? If the shear force at the critical section is 200 kN, what this shear force? It is a service load or design load? So there is nothing given like design shear force or factored shear force. It is simply given shear force at the critical section is 200 kN. That means V is equal to 200 kN. It is not VU. VU means it's a factored shear force. Okay. So you should be careful. Pay careful attention to the load that is given, whether it is a service load or a factored load or design load, whatever. Okay. The width of the support is 300 mm. Use M20 grade concrete, Fe415. So all those things is written here. So as soon as you start check the development length at support, you should go to your code, page number 40. I don't know what code is. So here in 42, page number 42, development length formula is given. LD is equal to pi into sigma s divided by 4 into tau bd. This is one formula. And they say this LD, and the next page below this, because you are cutting off some of the reinforcement, it says the LD computed in 26.2.1 should not exceed this formula M1 by V plus L0. So these are the two formula you have to check it. Okay. So here you will see to find development length LD. Right. So from page number 42, class 26.2.1, you have been given development length formula. LD is equal to pi is the nominal diameter of the reinforcement. These are all 20 mm only. So you will take 20 mm into sigma s is 0.87 fy. Okay. divided by tau bd, 4 tau bd. Okay. Now so from table 26.2 point, page number 43, now you have been given all this thing. Okay. Now these bars are in tension, right? These are all tensile reinforcement. This is in tension. What is the grade of steel? Grade of steel is Fe415. Now what is the value of tau bd for M20 grade concrete and Fe415 grade steel? What is the value of design bond stress from here? M20 grade concrete, Fe415 steel, and the bars are in tension. Okay, tensile steel. So what is the value? One of you please let me know. Tau BD value. This is the tau BD value. That's correct. That has come from, because for M20 tau bd is given as 1.2. that is only for the plain bars. Read here. Okay, that is only for the plain bars it is given. For a deformed bar, deform is Fe415 or Fe500, this value should be increased by 60%. That means 1.6 into 1.2, that is the value of tau bd, right? So if you substitute here, tau bd is equal to 1.2 newton per millimeter square for M20 grade concrete and for the plain bars. But your bar is not plain bar, it is Fe415 steel given. Fe415 steel is a deformed bar. So tau bd is equal to 1.6 times 1.2 for M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. And remember, this steel is a tensile steel, that is why you are stopping here. Suppose if it is a doubly reinforced beam, if compression steel is given and Fe415 is given, then you have to multiply this value with 1.25. that we will see later. Okay. So for now, tau bd for M20 concrete and Fe415 steel is 1.6 times 1.2 newton per millimeter square. That will come out to be 1.92 millimeter square. So tau bd is 1.92 newton per millimeter square. Now you substitute in this formula. Now, whenever you are develop, you are checking the development length. You have been written check the development length. You don't substitute where the value of pi. We will keep the pi as it is. For example, development length LD is equal to pi into sigma x divided by 4 into tau bd. So sigma s is 0.87 fy. That is 0.87 into 415. Pi is the nominal diameter of the bar. That is the nominal diameter. 4 into tau bd. 4 into tau bd is 1.6 times 1.2. That is 1.92. So if you calculate, that is coming out to be 47 times the diameter. You keep this as it is because we have to check whether this how it is coming. So development length is 47 times the diameter for M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. It will never change for M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. The development length LD is equal to 47 times the diameter of the bar. Okay, because this is a grade of steel and this depends upon grade of concrete and steel. So for M20 and Fe415, the development length is 47 times the diameter of nominal diameter of the bar. Okay, now this development length LD should be less than or equal to 1.3 M1 by V plus L0. Yesterday I was explaining to you, right? So here in this section, this LD, one second, I will make it little zoom. At simple support, it is here at simple support, positive moment tension reinforcements have been limited to a diameter such that LD computed from 26.2.1, that is LD is equal to pi into sigma s divided by 4 tau bd, that formula should not exceed this value M1 by V plus L0, where M1 is a moment of resistance of the section, okay, and V is a shear force, and L0 is the sum of anchorage beyond the center of the support, and this value can be increased by 30%. That is why as I discussed yesterday, at simple support the reinforcements are confined by a compressive reaction, so the M1 by V can be multiplied by 1.3. that's what I have done here. This development length should be less than or equal to 1.3 times M1 by V plus L0, where M1 is the moment of resistance at the section you are finding out your development length. Now right now we are finding out at support. Now if you want to find out, you have to find out moment of resistance first of all. V is given, V is vectored shear force. It should be V. So remember here, V is given as shear force at the section due to design load is given. So it is not V, it is VU. Okay, for the sign convention they have written V, but it is, they are saying it is a design load. So consequently, this also will be VU. This formula VU. Okay, right. So now, therefore, your this development length LD you found out to be 47 diameter here. 47 pi should be less than or equal to 1.3 divided by M1 by VU plus L0. Okay, it should satisfy. Now, to find out this, we have to find out what is the moment of resistance M1. Okay, so the next step is to find the moment of resistance M1. Now, how will you find out moment of resistance? You already know from unit 1 and 2. How will you find out actual depth of neutral axis for a singly reinforced beam? You know XU by D is equal to 0.87 FY AST divided by 0.36 SKBD. It is given in G1.1A in page number 96 of IS code, right? This and all you already know. Now, if you substitute for all this value, just cancel this D and D, you can find out what is the value of actual depth of neutral axis. So 0.87, FY is 415. AST at support, how much is available? AST at support, I have written in the given data. Out of 6 bars at the support, 1256 mm square, yeah. Out of 6 bars, only 4 bars are available at support. So 4 into 340. Okay, so if I substitute all these things, XU is equal to 0.87 FY. AST is 4 number of 20 mm diameter bar divided by 0.36, FCK is 20, this D and this D get cancelled, so only B is the 300. So my actual depth of neutral axis coming out to be 210 millimeters. This I am doing to find out moment of resistance, whether I am getting under reinforced or over reinforced. So actual depth of neutral axis is 210 mm. So what is the, from page number 70 you can find out what is XU limit by D for Fe415 steel, that is 0.48. Therefore your X, but D you do not know, right? D is not given directly to you, but it is given indirectly. D is equal to overall depth was given and effective cover is given. So overall depth minus effective cover will become effective depth 660 mm. Therefore XC limit is equal to 0.48. This D, if you take it this side, 0.48 into D, which is 660, 316.8 mm, whereas XC was 210 mm. So since XU is less than XC limit, it is an under reinforced section. So in under reinforced sections, which will yield first, steel or concrete? In under reinforced section, are you there? Hello. In under reinforced section, which will yield first, whether steel or concrete? In under reinforced section, which will fail first, steel or concrete? Steel. So you know moment of resistance equal to 0.87 Fy into AST into D minus 0.40 XC, which we have studied in unit 1. So you know all this value, 0.87. So moment of resistance, M1 is nothing but moment of resistance. Okay, so MER is equal to, which in this case it is represented by the symbol M1, is equal to 0.87 Fy AST into D minus 0.40 XU. Now if you substitute for all this value, D is 660, 0.40 XU, 210, you are getting M1 is equal to 259.26 into 10 power 6 Newton millimeters. So this is the moment of resistance, okay, this is the moment of resistance at the support. Okay, now check for development length. Okay, now from step 2 you know 47 times the diameter of the reinforcement should be less than or equal to 1.3 divided by M1 by VU plus L0. Okay, now remember, what is this L0 means? What is the L0? If you go back to the code, see here, L0 is nothing but sum of the anchorage beyond the center of the support. Sum of the anchorage beyond the center of the support and the equivalent anchorage value of any hook or mechanical anchorage at simple support and at the point of inflection. L0 is limited to the effective depth of members or 12 times the diameter, whichever is greater. Okay, so here the support width was given as 300 mm. Okay, so here the support width was given as, this is 300 mm. Okay, now center of support means it will be center, will be center, will be somewhere here, that is 150 mm. Okay, now if your this main reinforcement is provided beyond the center of the reinforcement, that length of that reinforcement is called L0. Is that clear? L0 is the distance of the bar beyond the center of the support. Whatever the length of reinforcement, tensile reinforcement available beyond the center of the support. Okay. Right now in this section, we are assuming the bars are not extended beyond the center of the support. We are putting bars only up to center only, okay, up to center only we are providing. That means your L0 will become 0, isn't it? This L0 will become 0 because we are not extending this tensile rod beyond the center of the support. Okay, so this become L0, 0. That means your 47 times the diameter should be less than or equal to 1.3 M1 by VU. So if you, and you already found out M1, So now we have to find out factored shear force. Factored shear force nothing but 1.5 times V. This 200 is the shear force due to this service load or characteristic load. So shear force due to design load or factored shear force is equal to 1.5 times 200, that is 300 kilonewton, which is 300 into 10 cube newton. Okay, so that's why if you calculate, if you substitute all this thing, you calculate pi 1.3, m1 is 259.26 into 10 power 6 from the previous step, vu is 300 into 10 cube, okay, and 47 I brought here. So your pi should be less than or equal to 23.9. And what is the pi of your rod? What is the diameter of the rod that are used here? Hello? 20 mm. Okay, so 20 mm is less than 23.9, right? So diameter of the bar should be less than or equal to 23.9 mm. So dia provided is 20 mm, so which is less than or equal to 23.9 mm. Therefore your check for development length is perfectly okay. Okay, so this is the check for development length. Is there any doubt, anybody? Anybody having any doubt? Only thing is, you have to find out this moment of resistance using the formula which we have derived in the unit 1, and we have subsequently used in unit 2 also many times. Okay, so this is the development length check. So at this effort you don't have to extend, it will be perfectly all right. So if there is any doubt, please let me know. Hello? Anybody have any doubt? Okay, so if there are no doubt, I will ask you to do one more problem. Problem is exactly same as before, but the effective depth is 500 mm. Okay, if the effective depth is 500 mm, you have to redo all the steps. Okay, so step 1, 2, 3 I am asking you to do it yourself. And finally, you will find out M1 value. For this case, if the effective depth is 500 mm, your M1 is coming out to be 186.72 into 10 power 6 Newton millimeters. Okay. So now, after finding out M1, same thing, same step. Step 4 will be check for development length. Now from step 2 again same thing, 47 times diameter should be less than or equal to 1.3 m1 by VU plus L0. I am repeating, please, when you go back, please do the step 1, 2 and 3 and check whether you are able to get this m1 value. Is that clear? You should find out this m1 value yourself. Then the fourth step is 47 times diameter, check for development length, should be less than or equal to 1.3 m1 by VU plus L0. Now again, assuming this L0 is 0, I am not extending my bar beyond the center of the support. So if I calculate this one, 47 times diameter should be less than or equal to this. If I substitute for M1 and VU, I am getting your diameter should be less than or equal to 17.21 millimeters. So diameter should be less than or equal to 17.21 millimeters, but what you have provided 20 mm. Now is it safe or not in a development length? is the check for development length is okay or not? Your diameter should be less than or equal to 17.21, but what dia is provided in your problem is 20 mm. So therefore the check for development length is not okay. It is not okay. You have to increase the length. So that means you have to provide L naught. Is there any doubt, anybody? If there is any doubt, please ask. If you have any clarification in this particular step, please ask. Okay, so since the check for development length is failed, what we are going to do, instead of assuming L naught equal to 0, we will take diameter as 20 mm only and then provide L naught accordingly. Okay, so since our check for development length is not coming out to be okay, right, what I am going to do, I am going to use pi as 20 mm in this formula and I will find out the value of L naught. That much of extra length of the reinforcement I will provide beyond the center of the support. Okay, so what will I do is modification of development length LD. So I know 47 times diameter should be less than or equal to this formula, 1.3 m1 by vu plus L naught. Now 47 times L diameter of the original bar is 20 mm, less than or equal to 1.3. This is the moment of resistance at support. This is the shear force plus L naught. So from this I can find out L naught. So L naught should be greater than or equal to 130.8 mm. Your L naught, that is the length of the reinforcement bar beyond the center of the support, should be greater than or equal to 130.88 mm. Okay, now I am providing 200 mm. Somebody could ask, why we are providing 200 mm? Why we are providing 200 mm? That is because, you see, this is the original rod, this is the center of support, this is 150 mm, this is 150 mm, so this also 150 mm, because your support width is 300 mm given in the problem. This is 150 mm, this is 150 mm. Obviously, you cannot provide the rod till the end. You cannot provide, you have to give some cover. Normally 25 mm cover is given, side cover is given for the beam reinforcement. So out of it, so 150, 25 if you reduce the cover, you are having only 125 mm you have, but you have to provide more than 130 mm. So obviously you have to go for a 90 degree bend. So if you are going for a 90 degree like this, you have to provide a 90 degree bend like this. When you go for a 90 degree bend, this total length, how will you find out? See here, this is a 90 degree bend as per IS code. Now this is 4 times the diameter is how much? 4 into diameter is 20 mm, so this should be 80 mm. Okay, and this is the k plus 1 diameter. So k is 4 plus 1, 5 into 20, it is 100. This is 100, this is 80, so 180 mm. So minimum you should have 180 mm, so I have provided 200 mm. And your code says the L naught is limited to the effective depth. Effective depth is 660 mm. Sorry, effective depth is 500 mm in this case, and 12 times the diameter, 12 into 20 is 240. Okay, so your L naught, this L naught value cannot be, one second I will write here, it cannot be greater than D or 12 times diameter of the bar, whichever is greater. So greater value is this one, this is for 500 mm, this 12 into 20 is 240 mm. So your value should satisfy this one. Okay, first of all you should satisfy this one. This is 4 times the diameter is 4 into 20, and this radius is k times the diameter. This is here, or you can take roughly, you can take k plus 1 diameter. From here to here, you can take k plus 1 diameter. So for deformed bar, it is k is equal to, if it is mild steel, k is equal to 2. For deformed bar, it is k is equal to 4. So 4 plus 1, 5 times diameter is 100. 4 times diameter is 80. So 100 plus 80 is 180. So I am providing, because and they are saying this is the minimum length, this is the minimum height, this is the minimum height. You can get little more also. So I have provided 200 mm. So this length together is called L naught. This length, this is called anchorage length. This L naught is called anchorage length. Anchorage length. It is measured from the center of the support till this point, that is anchorage length. Okay, so this is how you will be doing this. So is there any doubt in this one, anybody? Any doubt? Okay, but please go back and do these steps. Okay, this first three steps you should do, and find out this M1 value you are getting correct or not. Okay, without this you cannot solve this problem. Last year in the final exam, this was not, something else was. Okay, sorry. Okay, so this is one kind of problem where you have to find out the check for development length. Okay, the next problem, this is the last problem in a, I will see, I can do one more, but I will see. A simply supported beam of span 6 meter, effective size 400 mm by 450 mm, is subjected to an UDL throughout the beam, throughout the length. The beam is reinforced with 6 numbers of 20 mm diameters, Fe41 by bars. Determine the theoretical cutoff point and physical cutoff point. When 2 bars can be curtailed, when 4 bars can be curtailed, use M25 grade concrete. Okay, so first of all, you have to understand what the problem is. What they are saying is, suppose, let us say you have a simply supported beam subjected to UDL. Let us say this is W U kilo Newton per meter, and this span is L effective. Okay, now obviously you will have a bending moment of a parabolic variation, something like this, and this value is, what is the maximum bending moment in a simply supported beam subjected to UDL? What is its value? Wu into L effective square by 8, and your bending moment is keep on reducing towards the support this side also. Your bending moment is reducing this side also. So this 6 number of 20 mm bar is provided for this bending moment, Wu L effective square 8. So at the center, the 6 number of 20 mm diameter Fe41 by steel is provided for this bending moment. Okay, now the question they are asking is, out of which I want to, out of 6 bars, because at this end you don't need 6 bars, here also you don't need 6 bars, you can reduce it. So the question is, if I want to cut 2 bars, that means I want to have only 4 bars at this support. In the first case, 2 bars can be curtailed means at the support I have only 4 bars out of 6, 2 bars are curtailed, so only 4 bars are there. In second case, out of 6 I want to cut 4, so remaining only I want to have. So first I will work out for this one, and I will let you know what is the theoretical cutoff point, what is physical cutoff point by solving this problem. Okay, But for this, you should know some of the free body diagram and all. You should know. Okay. Anyway, we will just proceed. So what is given here is span is given. This span is a clear span or effective span? A simply supported beam of span 6 meters given. So since it is only span given, nothing about effective is mentioned. It is a clear span. L is equal to 6 meter. So B is 400 mm. Small d is 450 mm. And A is T 6 number of 20 mm bars at a maximum bending moment. Okay, I have written at maximum bending moment point. You have A is T 6 number of 20 mm. Now Fy is given as 415 MPa and Fck is 25 MPa. Now if you see, this is your simply supported beam with UDL throughout. Now I know at the center the bending moment is Wu L square by 8. Okay. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to take a section here, okay. I am going to take section here and draw a free body diagram. So first development length I am going to find out development length. So first, before that, I want to find out what is L effective. L effective is what? Clear span plus effective depth, that is 6.45 meters. Okay, 6.45 meters. Because support width is not given, so you cannot find out the second case. So whatever given values, out of that, L effective 6.45 meters. Now I am taking the this free body of this one. So I removed this off and bring it here. Obviously at the center, whenever you draw a free body diagram, whenever you make a section here, you have to replace with the corresponding internal forces and moments. So the internal moment at the center, what is the bending moment? What is the bending moment at the center? What is the bending moment at the center in a simply supported beam with a UDL? So that is what? Wu L square by 8, this is the bending moment. What is the shear force at this point? At a mid span? For a simply supported beam with UDL throughout, what is the bending moment or what is the shear force at this point? You should not think much. Zero. It is. Yeah, shear force is zero. So there is no vertical shear force here. Now what I am doing is, I am going to take a, one second, I will just erase this all ink. I am taking a section 1-1. At a distance x from the midpoint from this, okay, and I know this is Wu, okay, this is Wu kilo Newton per meter. Now what is a bending moment at this section 1-1? If you take from left side, what is a bending moment at 1-1 if you consider only left side? So bending moment at section 1-1 M11 here is equal to Wu L square by 8, that is a bending moment itself, that is a positive value, and for this UDL Wu into x square by 2. Okay, now why I am calculating this bending moment at section 1-1 is, see, at the center, to take care of Wu L square by 8, I need 6 reinforcements, 6 number of reinforcements. I am finding out distance x where four, because first I have to cut two bars. No, I am cutting it. Okay, two bars can be cutile. So now step this is step 3. There is something wrong here. So one second. This is step 3. Containment of bars, when two bars I want to cut, if you cut two bars, then there are four bars in the beam at the support, okay? So now, if you see here, pay attention, careful attention here. My six bar will resist the bending moment of WU L square by 8, okay? Now, I am trying to find out at which distance I can provide four bars to resist the corresponding bending moment, okay? So that is why in the previous one, I am finding out the x value. So if you substitute for all these values, all this WU will get cancelled, okay? All this WU will get cancelled here, this WU, this WU, this WU will get cancelled. L effective already found out. So you can find out the value of x. If you find out the value of x, x is coming out to be 1.732 meters. Let us say, this is equation 1. This value is x is equal to 1.732 meters of 1. Okay, so in other words, six rods can take care of this bending moment. Now I am going to cut to two bars, so I will have only four bars. Four bars has to resist this much bending moment, and this is the distance. Like previous, okay. Here this one. Oh, sorry. So I want to cut the reinforcement at this point here, okay? And I am saying the bending moment at that point is this one, okay? So I have to provide reinforcement up to here. Then at that point, that reinforcement can take this much moment. So that is why I am using that one. Six bars can this take this one? So four bars can take how much moment? So from this, you cancel all u and x, you are getting x is 1.732 meter. This is the first value. Now second value is, you have to use development length. Development length LD is equal to pi into sigma s divided by 4 tau vd. Pi is 0.87 fy. Sorry, sigma s is 0.87 fy. Pi is 20 mm diameter. 4 times tau vd. So remember this grade of concrete given is M25, I guess, right, in the problem. So if you see here in the code, for M25 it is 1.4, and for deformed for 1.6 into 1.4 tau vd value. So that is what it is written here. 4 into tau vd is 1.6 for Fe415 steel, 1.4 is for M25 grade concrete for the plain bar, okay? So LD is coming out to 0.806 meter. This is 2. Okay. So you have to find out this x value. You have to find out development length value. This is first equation. This is second equation. Now we will find out what is theoretical cutoff point, what is physical cutoff point. Theoretical cutoff point is nothing but greater of 1 and 2. Greater of 1.732 meter and 0.8 something meters. So obviously 1.732 meter or 1732 millimeter is the theoretical cutoff point. Actually, you can cut from the center, you provide the six bars up to 1.73 meter, 732 meter on both sides. Okay. After that, you can cut it off. Okay. So, now what is a physical cutoff point? Physical cutoff point is nothing but theoretical cutoff point plus greater of D into D and 12 times the diameter. This also given in your code. So if you come here, so here for containment, the reinforced shell extend to the point at which it is no longer required to resist the flexure for a distance equal to effective depth of the member or 12 times the diameter, whichever is greater. Okay. So that is the point we are discussing. So now TCP is how much? 1732. D is how much? That is given as 450 mm. 12 times diameter bar is 20 mm. So if you substitute all these things, TCP is 1732 millimeter plus greater of D is 450 mm. 12 into diameter is 12 into 20, it is 240 mm. So greater of 2450 and 240 is 450. So 450 plus 1732 is become 2182 millimeters. So this is the practical, you have to use this value. You should not use theoretical value, you have to use physical value, PCP. So if this is your beam, okay, this is the beam of 6 meter span, this is 6 meter span. Now this bars, that the bottom bar, they said 6 number of 20 mm diameter bars. Now if you want to cut off two bars, you want to cut it off, then what you have to do is, you have to provide this this part, this remaining for this two bars can be cut out for a length of 2.182 meter. After this it can be cut off. For 2.182 meter this bar has to be there, after that you can cut it off, okay. So that is the physical cutoff point. Now same thing, four bars are asked, you do it yourself, okay. So here I am going to see the plan of this one. So these are the, see, these four bars are there from here to end. This is a 6 meter span, this is 25 mm is the effective side cover, this is also 25 mm cover. So remaining is the four bars are there for a full length. For middle two bars are there only from the center of the point, you have 2.182 meter up to that it is there, remaining can be cut off. So next question was, how much should be the cutoff length, physical cutoff point, if four bars are getting cut off, okay. So that is the problem that you should solve yourself, and you should come up with the answer in the next class, okay.